HBO's Westworld utilizes a common narrative, one which follows the concept that human evolution will inevitably take us to the point where artificial intelligence is smart enough that we render humankind obsolete. This is an idea that was raised very early on by Isaac Asimov. In his essay The Machine and the Robot, he wrote, "The ultimate machine is an intelligent machine, and there is only one basic plot to the intelligent machine story, that it is created to serve man, but that it ends by dominating man. It cannot exist without threatening to supplant us, it must therefore be destroyed or we will be." And hence from that arises what is widely known as the Frankenstein complex, this fear of man broaching through technology into God's realm, and being unable to control his own creations. Asimov chose to add a motif in only a few of his stories, in which he denounced the Frankenstein complex. Although this wasn't something he believed in, he thought it made the stories somewhat more interesting. This, however, has remained in the root of most TV shows or movies, where conscious AI is at the center of the story. Many of the tropes in Westworld we've seen before, and not only in the original movie. Even the part where the hosts are not conscious of the fact that they are indeed robots. Similarly to Blade Runner, the hosts aren't hidden from us, but just like some replicants, they assume they are human.
She's a replicant, isn't she?
This allows for the hosts to be hidden in plain sight, adding an element of detection and deduction for the viewer, which works so well in an episodic format.
Took more than 100 for Rachel, didn't it?
She doesn't know.
I don't know. He may have moved them.
What's behind this door?
What door?
Here, though, is also where Westworld diverges. It mixes science fiction, one of the dominant genres in entertainment, with a previously dominant form, which has been long in decline, the Western, enabling the reconstruction of a lot of familiar visual cues and tropes by having the hosts act out any of the old Western cliches and get away with it, because it's considered parody.
Well, let this be a lesson. The lesson is...
Right now, Westworld resembles the future dressed in clothes of the past. This combination of influences sitting at the two ends of the entertainment spectrum, as well as the continuous mockery of old tropes, have made the show emerge as something seemingly new. Science fiction created from the past.